Hi guys, my name is Megan and today I've got a book review for Get a Life, Chloe Brown. All right, so I know everybody has read this book and everybody has loved it and I love this book too. It's amazing. So I really loved this book. Chloe and Red are so funny and so sweet and so cute together that they kind of make me blush a little bit, but you know, whatever, we're not going to talk about that. But Chloe and Red are just really sweet with each other. And even when they're arguing or like poking at each other and, you know, trying to get a rise out of the other, it's mostly good natured. And I love that about them. The things that I really, really, really enjoyed about this book were that Chloe is a chronically ill main character and we get to see her dealing with that and how it like plays into her everyday life, but also how it plays into her pushing her boundaries, but also having to live through the consequences of that. So whether that's, you know, being in pain all day or having to take extra rest days or, you know, just not having the energy to deal with things for days afterwards of, you know, having really great days. The other thing I really enjoyed about this was Red and how he was dealing with the fallout from a very, very toxic relationship and finding himself again and going to therapy. That was so good. I love that therapy was brought into this. And I love that when it's brought into books in any way, shape, or form, because therapy is not talked about a whole lot in books for characters to have trauma. And so nice to see, especially for a male main character, getting therapy and, you know, helping him work through his trauma. That's so good. I loved seeing Chloe and Red interact so much and just have this really great relationship that it may have gotten off to a little bit of a rocky start and had a rocky middle, but the way that they worked through things was so good. I really like that Chloe is just doing this list to, you know, make herself feel like a badass a little bit. And I love that Red sees her as a badass when Chloe really doesn't see herself that way. And it's just so cool and really, really nice. I think the only thing that I didn't like about this book was kind of that miscommunication thing that always happens in a romance book. It just, that's not my thing. And I feel like it doesn't come up that much in real life, but you know, I kind of like the way that things were dealt with after that and how they worked through that and worked through their growing pains for their relationship. And I really liked how everything ended after that. So honestly, it's not that super big of a complaint. So really, I guess I don't have anything to complain about because this book was really, really good. And it was very steamy and it was just so good. So this one got a full 5 out of 5 stars from me. I really enjoyed it and I would highly recommend it if you haven't already read it. If you guys like this video, don't forget to hit the like button. If you haven't already and would like to, go ahead and hit the subscribe button. And if you'd like to follow me on social media for more bookish stuff, check out the links down below. Alrighty, bye guys.